to more than this, we get the sense that Freddy takes William Afton's resurrection personally.
What was that? Are you okay?
He's trying to take control of me. I do not think I can fight it for long.
He? What is that thing?
Throughout the game, Freddy also acts differently to the other, more hostile animatronics. He makes several strange comments that allude to him being more than a mere robot AI. Here are a few examples.
It's like the whole place is trying to get me.
I am not.
Why?
I do not know. I want to help you. There you are. I was so worried. I will miss you.
This is all theory discussion, but my best interpretation of events at this time is that Freddy also contains a resurrected human soul, that of William Afton's son, Michael. Michael Afton also perished in the fire at this pizzeria, and it is therefore possible that his soul may be trapped in this location. We know Fazbear Entertainment frequently cuts corners and reuses parts from older animatronics. There is a decent possibility that some of these parts, much like the circuit board scanned for help wanted, were reused from this old location before the new one, the Megaplex, was built over it, allowing Michael's consciousness to return when Freddy was rebooted after the glitch trap hang. This explains why he is able to hold off his father's attempts to hack him during the climactic boss fight, his father versus son, over again. After burning Glitch Trap's resurrected several times, the Pizzaplex explodes, and the child souls trapped inside the scrap animatronics once again rise up to claim their tormentor, dragging him back to the animatronic hell he deserves. William may always come back, but he barely manages to stay for very long. After they light a fire to burn it to the ground. From the way Freddy says it's time to end this, we get more confirmation that he has a very aware, very human side to him. One who seeks to stop Fazbear Entertainment from harming anyone else. During their escape, Danny grabs Gregory, and as Freddy rushes over to help, both are sent careening over the rooftop, hitting the floor and dying on impact. Gregory unmasks Danny, and it is revealed that, yes, she is Vanessa. However, a post-credit sequence reveals Vanessa to be seemingly alive and well, looking down sorrowfully on the body of a person that looks just like her. So, twins, right? Well, my first reaction to this sequence, before spending time piecing everything together, was that yes, these two are sisters. But if we take into account our previous discussion of how souls become tied to the location they died in, then this ending instead serves as symbolism. It is simply saying that Vanessa was never saved from Glitch Trap's control, and so once Vanny dies, her soul remains forever restless and trapped inside the Mega Pizzaplex, leading further evidence to our Afton family resurrection theory. There isn't too much to say about the bad Vanny ending. During their trip through Phaser Blast, Gregory and Freddy discover a secret room near a catwalk above the arena. This is where Vanessa hid away and secretly hacked Fazbear's systems. Freddy, who has been attacked and dismantled by Vanny's rogue security bots, manages to guide Gregory to the override controls, turning the bots back on their master. This leads to Vanny's gruesome demise as she is ripped limb from limb by her own weaponized robots. We can gain information from this ending, however. Firstly, it confirms that yes, Vanny was responsible for hacking into the animatronics and causing them to go rogue. And secondly, a newspaper article states that despite the mess, Fazbear Entertainment once again plans to reopen in the future, basically confirming more locations and therefore games are coming soon. The final ending is what most would refer to as Security Breach's true closure. To unlock it, we must save Vanessa from her valley state, and to do this, we need to seek out and complete all three Princess Quest arcade machines. These pixel art themed video games originated from a mobile version of FNAF Help Wanted. Staff seemed confused as to why this game was ever ported to arcade cabinets, and even more confused as to the strange behavior these cabinets exhibit, refusing to work unless played in
order. Oh, hey there.
Seriously?